This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hey, what's up? Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV. So if you're planning on getting the 6th generation iPad mini, or if you already have one, here are 6 main tips and tricks that you can expand further, which you can apply to really maximize the potential of this tiny little beast of a tablet. So keep watching. First of all, let's talk about how really versatile the virtual keyboard is. Now, once you have the keyboard turned on, if you touch and hold the keyboard icon, you'll see there are several options for you to choose from. Firstly, there's the undock function where it raises the keyboard just above the bottom part of the screen, which allows you to see the bottom of the screen of the app that you're in. Next, there is the split keyboard, which makes typing on the keyboard easier as it literally splits the keyboard into two parts on the left and on the right, then makes typing way much easier using your thumb, whether or not you have it on a landscape or a portrait position. Then finally, there's the floating keyboard option to make the keyboard float around the screen to type on it, no matter where you place it on the screen. And here's where you can even do the swipe text feature to type a word, similar to what you get on the iPhone. And to restore the keyboard, just drag it back to the bottom of the screen. Now, if you notice that each character, there are special characters which is grayed out over here. Now, instead of typically hitting the 1-2-3 number pad to switch and use those characters or even numbers, you can just touch the gray out letters and drag down immediately to type that special character. Nicer. Then the final cool thing that you can do on the Apple's virtual keyboard is to use the space bar as a cursor. For example, if you have a typo and want to go to the selected text to adjust the wrong letter, instead of trying to touch accurately on where exactly you have made a mistake, just touch and slide the space bar and there'll be a sort of a cursor to help you to adjust accordingly. So yes, this makes the Apple's virtual keyboard way more functional compared to something like Google's Gboard app, which most people tend to do. Now here's something crazy but interesting that I had to try first before confirming that it works. And yes, it does. Now since the new iPad mini 6th gen comes with Touch ID, which you can unlock the iPad with your fingerprint, well, other than unlocking with your fingerprint, try registering your palm instead, or the side of your palms, where you can register both your palms no matter what orientation that you have the iPad in. Now this way, unlocking the iPad will be even more natural if you're holding the tablet in a landscape position, no matter which side that you hold it. Alright, since the iPad mini now comes with a USB-C port instead of the Lightning port, it also means that there are tons of connectivity options that you can have on the iPad mini. Firstly, you can connect a USB-C hub, and with this, you can have extended connectivity options to have even more things to put on, such as an SD card or even a HDMI connection as well. Now, you can even connect a USB-C SSD or an NVMe storage, or alternatively, you can get a USB-A to USB-C dongle to connect it with an external hard drive if it requires for you to use USB-A 3.1 instead. Now, if you like to take your iPad mini on more of a mini desktop experience, you can get a little stand to prop it up as a mini monitor, and then you can connect your Bluetooth mouse and keyboard, which was really nice in terms of browsing, or if you're like me who keep on writing scripts and even answering emails on the tablet. Now, if you have a PS5 controller, you can also connect it and play games on it as well. Now, what's also nice is that since it has a USB-C port, it also means that you can even charge other devices such as your iPhone. And since the Apple Watch Series 7 comes with a USB-C connection, you can even plug the charger or the MagSafe charger on the USB-C port to charge your Apple Watch. Alright, since the new iPad mini does support the second generation Apple Pencil, there's more that you can do instead of just writing it and also using it as a drawing tool. And here are some tips on using it. Other than typically holding the power button and the volume rocker to take a screenshot, you can also just swipe from the bottom left towards the middle of the screen with the Apple Pencil to take a screenshot. Then of course you can draw or write on the screen accordingly, making it great for any situations where if you like to take notes on a particular website or picture that you come across. Now if you like to take a note very quickly, you can just swipe at the bottom right of the screen instead, where it brings up the quick note, where you can either use the Apple Pencil or just type in a note. And then once you hit done, you can bring it back at any point of time and it brings back where you left off, since it's already saved in your notes app. Now, what's also very neat about this Quick Note feature is the fact that if you have the website open and if you have the Quick Note screen on, you can directly add the link of the website on the notes as well, instead of typically copying and pasting the website address. And on top of that, if you go back to that website where you got your link saved, a small thumbnail for the Quick Note will appear towards the bottom right as well to kind of give you that sort of a reminder that you've taken a note on that website, and that was super sweet. Then there's also lots of scribble features, like if you select the pen with the A icon, it will automatically turn your handwriting into text. And yes, I've tested this feature on other tablets and nothing comes this close when it comes to the accuracy with the Apple Pencil over here. Then you can cross a text to delete a text. Drawing a line through the words selects them, or even drawing a circle around them. Next, touching and holding down backspaces the text, or just draw a vertical line in between the words to add a space. And also, this scribble feature works on the search bar on Safari to enter a website address as well. Now, while there are a lot of improvements on the latest iPad OS 15, here are some things that I found it very extra useful for you to use on the iPad mini. So like the iOS 15, the Spotlight search makes it easy to search for anything, whether or not it's on your iPad or on the internet, where all you have to do is to swipe in the middle of any of the home screen to go to the Spotlight search, where not only you can search for your apps, but search for anything on the web in relation to what you're searching. Now, sometimes there are certain websites or apps by default which has a smaller font, since they are not really made for tablet and probably made for more of a smartphone experience instead. Now, here's where you can easily use the text size indicator at the control center, where just in case it's not there, you can edit through the control center settings under the settings app. So with this cool feature, you can easily adjust the text for not only for the settings app, but also the whole entire iPad mini screen, which was really neat. Now, having multitasking windows on an iPad or any tablet is definitely a huge must, and doing it on the iPad mini is super simple. So for example, if you open up any app, for this case, YouTube, there'll be a three dotted indicator in the middle, and after selecting it, you'll have two multitasking options, where firstly, there's the split view, where you can choose another app to split with, for example, opening Safari while your YouTube video is being played. Then, of course, you can drag the bar in the middle to make any application to have a smaller or a bigger screen. And if you want to go back to the full screen, just choose the app and hit the three dots once again and hit the full screen option, which is the very first option. Then the other multitasking option is the slide over option, where once you click the three dotted lines and select the second slide over option and open a second app like Safari or even Apple Music, here's where you can have YouTube still while you can browse through Safari and the Apple Music app as well. And this makes it very interesting that you can actually switch between both of the apps just by swiping the pop-up window to switch between any apps that you can add accordingly. Then there's also some minor updates on the iPad OS 15, which is very useful indeed, like the customized widgets that you can place it anywhere on the screen. And you can now also add pages and delete pages to really customize the look of your iPad mini as well. And finally, not only the app library is on the iPad, but now you don't have to go all the way to the last page of your iPad mini, but you can find the app library, which is now available in the dock as well. Then there are other super cool features that you can integrate your iPad mini with your Mac, like Sidecar that turns your iPad mini into a secondary display wirelessly. And with the latest Mac OS Monterey update, you can now use Universal Control to use the same mouse and keyboard to use it between your iPad mini and your Mac as well. And also worth mentioning is that you can also integrate the Mac and also the iPad mini by right-clicking on your home screen of your Mac and choosing Import from iPad to add a sketch, take photos, and scan documents, where once you're done, it will appear on your Mac's desktop. So yes, this would come in super handy in various type of work or personal situations, like signing a document or scanning documents for a digital copy of whatever you have. Then as for tip number 6 would be using Pro Apps for maximum creativity on the iPad mini. While there are tons of apps that you can choose, there are some apps that I would say would totally elevate your experience using the iPad mini. Where firstly, there is Luma Fusion, where as mentioned in my iPad Pro video, it is the best and the most advanced video editing app on any portable devices right now. Another pro and a cool app is Canva, which is an app that I use a lot in my social media pages, like creating my Instagram stories posts, creating a presentation deck, a YouTube thumbnail, and lots more over there. Then finally, I would totally recommend for you to try Procreate, which is an amazing sketch and paint app, which is perfect to use on the iPad mini, especially with the Apple Pencil. Now, if you're wondering, but Adam, I have no idea to use these apps, man, it's too advanced for me. Well, here's where this video sponsor comes in, which is Skillshare. So Skillshare is an online learning community where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey with thousands of inspiring classes. Now, it does not matter if you're a beginner or a pro, you can learn everything within your interest. And what's nice is that most classes are under 60 minutes, so it fits well to fit any schedule. And recently, I've been learning a lot from Vashti Harrison on illustrating on Procreate. And another amazing class that I love is about the Canva app, which is done by Maggie Strara on social media content creation in Canva from beginner to advanced. And finally, I've been tweaking my video editing skills on the go from Stuart Little on learning to edit video using LumaFusion. So the good news is that for the first 1,000 of my subscribers, which is you, to click at the link at the description, you'll get a free trial of the premium membership so you can explore your creativity. And thank you Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Alright guys, those are my 6 tips that I would recommend for you to maximize your usage on this iPad mini. And if you found this video helpful, do give this video a nice big thumbs up and share this video to anyone who you think would find it beneficial to use or to make a purchase of the iPad mini 6th generation as well. Aside from that, thank you so much for watching. My name is Adam Lovo and I'll see you in my next video.